In this part, we will continue conducting hydrologic modeling using the HEC-GeoHMS program. And after we finished entering the data and parameters for the dams, which include Dibis, Sartik, Taktak, and Dokan, we will enter the data for the meteorologic models, which includes the weather data obtained from the global weather data for SWAT, and these weather data for the study area exist on the desktop in this file, which contains the weather data with the TXT extension and CSV extension, as we see. And we will use the weather data in the Excel files with the CSV extension, which contain the following fields. Data, longitude, latitude, elevation, max temperature, mean temperature, precipitation, wind, relative humidity, and solar. Then we go to the project in HEC-GeoHMS program, and in it we go to the meteorologic models. Then we press on laser zap. Then we go to the meteorologic models menu. Then in the units system, we choose metric. Then we specify the options as we see. Then we press on the precipitation gauges. The gauge name in the study area appears. And for example, in the subbasin W1200, we can choose the data according to the weather data in the Excel file. And we will not choose them here. Then we go to the time series data. Then we go to the precipitation gauge. Then we press on the first station titled P351431. Then in the units, we choose cumulative millimeters. And in the time interval, we choose 1 day. In order to obtain the daily precipitation data for the first station in this subbasin, we copy the name of the first station. Then we go to the file that contains the daily weather data. For the study area from the global weather data for SWAT, and in it we go to the search field and we paste the station name. And we delete the letter P from the name. Then we make a search, then the exit file with the CSV extension of the weather data for the first station appears. Then we open it. And in it, we go to the precipitation field. Then we go to the project in HEC-GeoHMS program and we specify the date and time for the data as we see. Then we go to the table menu. Then we activate the daily precipitation data for the first station in the exit file. Then we copy them. And we go to the HEC-GeoHMS and we paste the data in the table of the first station. Then we preview the data in the graph menu. Then we check the data as we see. Then we input the daily precipitation data for the rest of the stations in the same way as we see. and so on for the rest of the stations. By that, we have finished inputting the daily precipitation data for all the precipitation gauges or stations in the study area basin. And we will continue the implementation in the next parts. Then we save the project by pressing on Save.